So far, we have spoken about only arrays as the data structure we can define and create. Arrays are great, but they have a small problem because arrays can only store data of the same type. Now let us say you want to store a student's name, address, age, roll number, gender. Now you are in a problem. Because if you have to use arrays for this, you will be required to create 5 or 6 arrays to store the data. But fortunately, most of the programming languages come to your rescue using, suppose, something called as the record. So the advantage of a record is you can group related data having different data types in the same block. And that is known as a record in most of the programming languages. In C, it is referred to by the keyword structure. So a structure in C language allows you to group data of different data types, but having some relationship between each other. For example, name is a character, age is an int. But although they are different data types, there is a certain relationship between the person's name and an age. That is known as a structure. Now let us say we want to keep related information of a student, like the name of the student, his roll number or her roll number, age and gender. In that case, what we would do is we would simply come ahead and declare a structure like this. So just look at the declaration very carefully. This struct is a keyword. This is the name of the model. I'll tell you what the model or prototype is. This is the first field, roll number, care name 50, age, I've purposely given float so that you can see data of different types, all right? And then gender is a character which will either be M, F or O for others. Now, you need to understand something very important here. This thing here does not occupy any memory space because this is just a declaration of a blueprint or a model or a prototype. Let me tell you in a more simple words. Let us say you have to build a house. You will go ahead to the architect. The architect will give you a plan or a model or a template. Is that the actual house? No, it is not the actual house. So same here, this is the model or a template or a prototype. Based on this model or the blueprint, we can create variables of this particular type. We'll come to that as and when we jump there. Now you need to understand, these do not occupy any space or no memory is allotted to them because they are merely a model. When we create variables of the type struct student underscore info, then variables are defined and space is allocated for each structure, as many structures as we create. Some technical terms, this roll number, name, age and gender, in structures they are known as members of a structure. So these are all members of a structure, this name, age, roll number and gender. All that you are doing here is you are just specifying the data type. You are saying roll number is int, char is name of 50, age is float and gender is char. So this is how you go about declaring a structure. Now, the major part is over because you have defined a model or a blueprint of a structure. Now suppose you want to define a structure variable. Here you are declaring a structure. Declaration only indicates the model. Definition actually allocates space for a variable. So suppose here I say struct student underscore info and I say student. Now a variable called student is going to be created, which will have all these particular items as a part of it. So student is the first variable where memory is allocated. Now if you have to refer to all the individual members, you don't directly say roll number, name, age and gender. You got to use something called as the dot operator. And using the dot operator, you will refer to the individual members. For example, to refer to student underscore roll number, you will say student dot roll number. To refer to name, you will say student dot name. To refer to age, you will say student dot age. To refer to gender, you will call student dot gender. So the moral of the story here is, this is a blueprint or a model. This is an actual variable of this particular blueprint. And individually, these names, roll number, age, gender, don't mean anything. They are always associated with this particular structure called as student. So to refer to age, I will always have to say student.age. If I try to say print age, the compiler will flag an error, because age on its own does not have any existence. Age has an existence only because of student. Alright. Now, to further enhance your conceptual clarity, let's take a look at a diagram here. This is going to really help you understand things a little better. Let's say I have declared a structure called as sample. It has age as one of the members and it has got character ID with the width 5. Let us assume for convenience the width of age is 4 bytes. So this is how your structure will look conceptually. Age 99 and let's say ID is X01. I have not shown the null character because that's not really important. Conceptually, this particular structure, assume I create a variable of this particular structure, I am going to have an allocation which looks something like this. Let us say the structure variable is allocated memory starting from address 1000. So integer is 4 bytes. So 1000, 1001, 1002, 1003 is all going to be storing information related to the age. So totally age is going to have 32 bits or 4 bytes available for it to be stored. Now char ID is 5. So from 1004 till 1005, 6, 7 and 8, you are going to all have one character which is going to be allocated for this array of characters or strings called as ID. The last position, of course, you got to use it for null. So you have 4 spaces available to store any character. So this column is the address. This column is how the data is represented. Don't confuse here that age is stored 4 times. All that it indicates is there are 4 bytes available for age to be stored. Similarly, there are total of 5 bytes available for ID to be stored, 1 byte including for the null character. So the moral of the story here is quite simple. Arrays help you to store related data of the same data type. Structures allow you to group related data, but the individual members of the structure can have different data types, and most often they do have different data types. Now, in C, structures are created or declared using this keyword called as struct. And this is a sample representation of how structures will look in main memory. All right, this is a conceptual representation.